Welcome to DP Tutorials by Donnie Jarwa. In this teaching module, again, we will emphasize on the energy which is stored in a capacitor. So we have learned that a capacitor is nothing but a device which stores charge. And when you want to store charge inside a capacitor, that means we have to have a battery. Say if I consider this capacitor, and if I want to store charge across this capacitor, that means I have to have a battery. This will be a battery. One end of the capacitor, one end of the battery will be positive, will have positive polarity, and the other end will be having a negative polarity. Now current will be flowing through the circuit, and then that means charge will be deposited. If charge will be deposited, that charge Q will be deposited on this capacitor. Now, there will be some chemical energy associated with the battery. This chemical energy which is associated with the battery, that means the energy which is stored inside the capacitor will be in the form of potential energy. Okay? So from here, keep in mind that the energy which is stored inside the capacitor is due to the chemical energy from the battery. And this chemical energy from the battery gets stored or gets converted into its relevant or corresponding potential energy, and this energy will be used up in charging the capacitor. So we already know that since there is a battery, there will be potential, and due to this potential, there will be charge accumulation. Okay, there will be charge accumulation. So we have learned that the capacitance of the capacitor, is given by the formula C is equal to Q divided by V. So the corresponding voltage, with the corresponding voltage from here, making use of this equation, V will be equal to Q, Q divided by C, Now, see, like for instance, if I want to transfer a small amount of charge, see that small amount of charge is dQ. So over here, suppose if I want to give small amount of charge dQ, then what do you have to do? There should be some work done. Then you also know that if there is a relationship between voltage, workdone, and charge, voltage or the potential difference or the electric potential is defined as the workdone per unit charge. If you want to transfer this charge or move this charge, that means there will be some work done associated with that charge. So from here, making use of this formula, I will write the small work done. What is that small work done? That small work done is given by dW. Okay? Small work done dW. Okay? dW will be equal to 1 V dQ. Okay? V dQ. And what is this V? If we mark this as equation number 1, V will be equal to Q divided by C, and this will be equal to dQ. Now this work done is in charging the capacitor, is stored in the capacitor as 1, is stored in the capacitor as its potential energy, And from here, if you are considering only for a small charge, that means you have to there will be some work done. Then the total work done in charging the capacitor, from Q is equal to 0 to Q is equal to Q is given by some equation. Then from here, let me emphasize again. Suppose if you want to transfer the charge, say from Q is equal to 0, okay? Say if you want to transfer the charge from Q is equal to 0. So from here, this will be Q equal to 0 to the total charge, which is Q equal to Q. Then what you have to do? You have to integrate the equation. So how will you integrate the equation? So we will mark this as equation number 2. So on this equation number 2, that means that total work, okay, that total work, that is, okay, W, the total work will be integration of dW. Integration of dW is W. And then from here you have to integrate both sides of that equation, then you have Q divided by C into dV. Then from here you have to look onto this equation, okay, you have to look onto this equation that this Q is a term which is dependent upon dQ. So I will take 1 by C outside because this is that integer which is independent of dQ. So you will have only 1 by C, this will be 1, Q dQ. Then over here you'll have 1 divided by C. Integration of Q dQ will give you 1. Q to the power 1 plus 1 divided by 1 divided by 1 plus 1. And keep in mind that since you are charging the capacitor from Q is equal to 0 to Q is equal to Q, you have to introduce the limits of integration. Okay, you have to introduce the limits of integration from Q is equal to 0 to Q is equal to Q. Even from here also 0 to Q. And from here put the limits from 0 up to Q. Then if you keep on solving, you'll find out that this will be equal to 1 by C. This will be Q to the power 2 divided by 2. And then the limits of integration going from 0 up to Q. Going from 0 up to Q. Then from here, this will be 1 by C. Then you have to put upper limit minus the lower limit. So what is the upper limit? Q. In place of Q, you put by Q. Then you get simply Q. Q squared divided by 2. And then when you put over here, 0 divided by 2 whole squared, this term will reduce to 1. This term will simply give you only 0. This term will simply give you 0. So next final step, you'll get only the equation of Q square divided by 2C. This is the work done. But mind you that this work done gets stored. This work done is stored on the capacitor. That means this work done, okay, this work done is stored in the capacitor. This work done is stored in the capacitor as its, okay, as its, this work done is stored in the capacitor as its potential energy, okay, potential energy. So we'll denote by U. Yeah, in this equation will denote by U, and that U representing energy of the capacitor will be given by Q square, okay? Q square divided by QC. This is one expression in which U is expressed, okay, in terms of charge Q and the capacitance of the capacitor C. Capacitance of the capacitor C. Then also you will have to rewrite this potential energy U in another form. Okay, we know that this V is equal to Q divided by C. We know that V is equal to Q divided by C, and this Q will be equal to C into V. Now when we substitute on this equation, okay, when we put on this equation, suppose if I'll mark this as equation number 3, okay, therefore 3 implies, okay, 3 implies this will be U and this will be equal to 1. In place of Q, you put by this equation. In place of this Q, you put by CV. So this will be CV whole thing square divided by twice C. If you solve, that means 1C from here and 1C from there will get cancelled. So you'll get CV square divided by 2, or U will be equal to half CV square. This will be one potential energy which we can say that it is another form, which is in terms of the capacitance C, and okay, which is in terms of the capacitance C and the voltage V. Then also we know we can also write in terms of Q and V. Okay, Q and V. Also, we know that C, okay, C is equal to Q divided by V. Now, if I take the reciprocal of C, then I will get V divided by Q. Okay, V divided by Q. So when I put on that equation 1, okay, replacing 1 by C, or equation 3 I mean, then you have here Q square divided by 2. In place of this C, 1 by C, we will put by 1. V divided by Q. This Q and 1Q from here, it will get cancelled. So you get QV divided by 1. QV divided by 2. Or U will be equal to QV divided by 2. This will be another expression of the energy of the capacitor. This will be another expression of the energy of the capacitor in terms of Q and V. So these expressions are very, very important from examination point of view, and this will be a first form, okay, equation of C in terms of this will be the first form of potential energy in terms of Q and C. This will be the second form of the energy stored in the capacitor in terms of what? C and V. This will be the third form of the energy of the capacitor, which is stored in the form of what? In the form of Q and V. So all these are important. Okay? All these are important from examination point of view. This will be the first form. This will be the second form. And this will be the third form. So these are important for numerical problems. Okay? All these equations which are marked 1, 2 and 3 are important for solving some numerical problems. But mind you, when you solve the numericals of all these U, the SI unit of U will be in terms of what? SI unit of that U should be recorded in terms of joules. Okay? Should be recorded in terms of joules. So if you have confusion for all these derivation, you just go through the lecture so that you can comprehend. Thank you.